So you've updated Final Cut Pro to version 10.7. But what happens when you try to open one of the earlier libraries from 10.6? As you most likely know, you'll be asked to update any previous libraries as you attempt to open them in 10.7. This in turn means that you can't open those updated libraries with the previous versions of Final Cut Pro. I'll show you how to open one of those updated libraries with the previous version of Final Cut Pro, 10.6. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that I can make more videos like this for you. Of course, if you'd thought of it, you could have duplicated the 10.6 library before upgrading to run in 10.7. And this is how to do that. When you're asked to upgrade, first select the 10.6 library in the Finder and right-click to duplicate. And this will take up the same amount of disk space as the original library, so your hard disk is going to fill quickly if you do this with every library. A better way to take up less disk space is to only convert the libraries that are needed. So how do you do that after the library's been converted? The answer's not obvious, but it's almost as simple. Open up the new Final Cut Pro 10.7 library. You'll need the 10.7 version, of course. Select the library in the browser, and from the file menu, export XML. Select the most recent version of XML and save into a folder with the original updated 10.7 library. And if you want to be sure that the media will be available for the converted library, you may want to consolidate the media before converting. Click the link above for a video on how to consolidate. And if you're frequently switching between Final Cut Pro 10.6 and 10.7, I've got a video about a quick and easy method of how both versions can be available without shutting down the computer. But you'll need to quit one version before opening the other, as both can't be active at the same time. Select the video in the link above. Anyway, let's get on. Once you've saved the XML, launch the previous 10.6 version of Final Cut Pro. Create a new library by the same name as the 10.7 library, but add 10.6 version to the name so you know which one is which later. From the file menu, select Import, XML. Now the XML should link up to the media from that original library. And if it doesn't all link up, use the Relink Files command from the file menu and select Original Media. From the window that pops up, select the missing files and relink. Click the link above to see a video on how to relink files. Now the library that was updated to 10.7 will be able to be opened in Final Cut Pro 10.6. So in essence, you've converted it back from 10.7 to 10.6. And if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that you'll be notified when I publish the next video about the 10.7 upgrade. That's about the changes to the roles feature that can now be applied to video as well as audio. Thanks for watching.